My family is torn apart. My husband ran away on 20th June 2022. Seven elephants destroyed my cassava garden. I can't say I'm a farmer. I am no longer growing food. I am now buying food. But it is very expensive because we are buying a benson of maize flour at 50,000 shillings. They say animals are everywhere, including crocodiles at the lake where they fetch water. They want the government to harmonize the situation because their children are at a risk of getting killed by the animals. We have been coexisting with the park, but these days, animals are attacking us. There are crocodiles on the lake where we fetch water. So we request the government to give us alternative water sources because the lake is no longer safe. We also request the government to talk to the park manager to respond to our calls in time.
When I see the elephant, as big as it is, we cannot coexist with them. My worry is, I think all the methods we have tried, but the problem is we don't have community sensitization by what?
We are always forced to run off in the case of an attack due to fear of our lives because the animals are hunting people and killing our animals. We are forced to hide in our houses until we feel that we are out of danger. Leaders say the problem is getting out of hand and want Uganda Wildlife Authority to address the issue immediately.
Bulisa sub-county, whereby 50% of the population is affected, followed by Ngwedo sub-county, whereby 30% of the population is affected.
For purposes of maintaining evidence and having empirical evidence in nature, there must be quick response to every call towards the destruction of crops, destruction of property, the loss of lives.
Before even we were born, we were coexisting well with the national park. And by then, we had small challenges. The challenges were human beings going to the park collecting firewood.
According to Innocent Wako, a ranger from Makshan, the human-wildlife conflict escalated after the government degazetted some of the game parks to allow human settlement. He has advised locals to stop sneaking into the park to poach and collect firewood, among other reasons.
We were all in gazetted area, but because this government, our own government, listened to people, Afandara, this the area was given. The papers, the Wildlife Act never recognized buffer zones.
While in Bulisa earlier this week, the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, Ruth Nankabira, trashed allegations of human-wildlife conflict in the district to have originated from the ongoing oil development.
Some people may think it's because of the discovery of oil, which is not the case because we are having this conflict all over the country.
Story by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.